Catherine from Art K in Ashted. Today we're going to be doing a waterbuck. This is a photograph we took on holiday when we were on the safari. And this is what it's going to look like in the end. This is an artist called Kerby Rosanes, who does lots of little creatures and things inside the animal. A little bit like Zentangles, but not with patterns. And this is the actual picture that we're going to do. Okay. So let's get on with it. Hi, so now we're going to start doing the waterbuck. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to do like two little mountains. The first mountain going to the second mountain, like so. We're going to put the horns, one over here. They're quite thick. One over here. And then we're going to put one over here and one over here. Okay, so the next bit is to do, to go down towards his nose, like so, and like so on the other side. Now his nose is like this. It's another sort of two mountains, like the top of his head. And there's almost like a heart shape for the front of his nose, which is very pretty. And then you've got the nostrils, one nostril, two nostrils. And let go to there. And then you have the mouth. They're very graceful waterbuck and glide along very elegantly. We're going to have an eye on the right hand side, like so, and we're going to have a pupil, and we're going to do light, sort of one line here and one line there, and that's the light going into the eye. And they have eyelashes at the top and at the bottom. The second eye is going to go over here. When we were on safari, we went to our tent, and there was this waterbuck just standing there right by the entrance. It was really magical because it was night time and we hadn't seen him, and he was just so quiet, and he just elegantly ran away. It was lovely. There we go, the eyelashes and then the two lines going through. Okay. The next thing is one of the ears. The ears are pretty big. And they come down. And then the line comes down and then softly goes round, like so. And then they have the other ear, which goes again up and around a bit more. If you do make a mistake, don't worry, just leave it. Just use a nice soft pencil, and at the end you can always rub it out if you want to, rather than stopping and rubbing it out when you're in the middle of drawing. Then there we go. So the shape inside the ear is an interesting shape. It's a bit like the mountain again. So you go up and you go down, and you go up and you go down. And on the other side, you go up, you go down, down. Like that. Okay. And then inside this here, you have
lots of fur. And the same for this one, some fur. It joins there, and then you have some dark bits here. And some dark bits here. You can see it needs to come up a bit. Around like that. Next thing is to do another line here. We're going to do some patterns now. A bit like our same tangles. Because Kerby Rosanes, he uses patterns too. Let's do a thin one here. And another one. So this is a bit like an extension of the Zentangles, doing lots of little creatures and things. And then we're going to do this as a pattern. We're going to do some circles. Inside the circles, we're going to do another circle, and then another one here, and then do lines going outwards. And then go up and down. And down, up and down, up and down, up and down. Make those dark when we do it with the pen. Okay, this bit here is the nose. It goes like that. That goes like that. And then they have these markings like this near their eye. Like that. Okay, now for doing some of the interesting little pictures. The first one we're going to do is a little swirl. Like so, and we're going to do a little creature like this, and a kind of plant, and we'll also do a rose. Like that. Next we're going to do a very funny creature, and he's a bit like sort of a thing you'd see on Ghostbusters. Like that. And coming from there we're going to have flower, then another flower, fill up some of the space, little circles. Then we're going to have a tree. Like so, and we're going to have a toadstool. I think we'll have it. It's a Fly Garrick toadstool. And then we're going to have a strange creature again. He's going to have kind of a curly thing in his mouth and rather grumpy looking face. And I think we're just going to do a kind of snake like thing here. Okay, and here I'm going to do another rose. Okay, on the next one, we're going to do another toadstool. And we're going to do a fan. And another creature like this. Looks a little bit like a lion. And we're going to have an octopus leg. Just have to imagine that the rest of the octopus. There we are, the octopus leg. Now we're going to have something like a mobile phone, which is very odd amongst octopuses. And we're going to have a kind of cat come dog. Slanty eyes, and we're going to make him into the king of dogs. We're going to have another strange creature. And we're going to put some circles as well. Then last at the top, we're going to do a pencil, a bent pencil. And another flower. Okay, so, with your black pen, we're just going to outline them. So first outline this interesting looking creature with the grumpy face. Then a toadstool. Have you ever seen a toadstool which is called Fly Garrick? It's red with the cap is red with white spots. Well, I saw some this winter. I saw six of them, and it was very exciting because I've never seen a Fly Garrick. Fly Garricks are special because they're poisonous. And they're the only ones that are red in our country anyway. And they're all there in a clump. And it was very exciting. Because it's something I'd always wanted to see. I used to be really into finding toadstools when I was young. I remember once collecting a whole basket full of toadstools and taking them to school very excitedly to show my biology teacher. She didn't actually seem that impressed. I think she was just thinking that she had a whole load of toadstools she had to get rid of. She didn't see my enthusiasm. Right, we're doing another funny one. He's got a smiley face. And the rose at the bottom. And then over here. Little swell. This looks like a little flower. And then a plant. As you're doing this, if you could think of other things that you want to do, just include them. I'm going to put something like, I'm going to put a woolly hat here. I don't know why. With a bobble on it. Put some more circles. I don't know why I like circles. Okay, so on to the other side. Start with this one. Yeah, so you can do hot air balloons, anything you like. That's the fan. Another fungi. An octopus leg. A mobile phone. A dog cat. Give it some whiskers. And its slanty eyes. Crown. A little bit of a flower. A grumpy ghost. Okay, here we're going to do some swirls. We're going to do hot air balloon. we're now going to do all the lines like that in book pen. Down here. And the heart nose. Okay. Over and the circles, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The first one has a second circle. So does the third one. So does the fourth one. The fifth one. Can't count. And then all the way over. So there. There we go. And then up and down. One like so, and then outline this one, outline this one, do the fur, make it nice and random so they're not all the same length, a little bit more realistic, and then over. A lot of those sort of shapes here, this kind of shape, see that shape here, see this shape here and here, it's interesting. And do the fur on this side. Again, making it random. Won't all look the same. not the same length. And then okay, how are we doing? And do it on the other side. Okay, then come down. Okay, let's fill in some more of these gaps. I'm going to put a sideways umbrella here. There. Just because I fancy it, and because you can put anything you like anywhere. And I'm going to put a cake here. With a birthday candle on. And I'm going to put some buttons. There. Maybe some buttons here. Okay, so the next thing you have to do, let me just show you. So the next thing we have to do is do the fur, and we have to go inside all that. So the fur is like this, lots of little back to front C's. And then this side, they are the right way round C's. And then we've got the C's here again. You don't have two people the same size. Again, all the same shape. Here we go. It's beginning to look good. Why did I say he? I wonder if it's a he or she. And you do exactly the same with the body, with the C's. You don't have to draw these in first with pencil, you can just go ahead with your pen. If you feel like doing a fur in a different way, please do. Okay, let's keep on. on going. My hand's going to fall off. You don't have to do this picture all in one go. You can always come back to it. As I said at the introduction, if you can find an animal that you'd like to do in this style after you've done this one, that would be a great idea. You could choose anything you like. You could choose a lion or a hippo, a dinosaur, a mammoth. Doesn't matter what you choose. You could do a whale or a shark. Maybe there. Okay. Now with the pencil, this is a 6B pencil. So it's a darker pencil, softer. You start penciling in. Give it more depth. If you wanted to paint it with watercolours, you could do that as well. Right, then you go in between all these, which makes them stand out. As I do it, you should see the picture standing out more obviously. There we go. Then I'm just going to give it a bit of a rub. It's a bit better, isn't it? Okay, now pencil in this section. You could even just put the odd colour in, like the toadstool. You could just paint the cap in red acrylic, or I suppose even use a Sharpie, just so that you have two or three or four, maybe five or six things which are coloured in. That might look quite nice. The crown here. Okay. Then this bit here, the buttons. as well as the cake. A hot air balloon. Okay, and then on the other side. Over here. The rest of the ear here. And do the same on this side of the ear. Careful you don't use just an HB pencil because you won't get the same effect. You need a darker, softer pencil. Okay, so the next thing is to shade this bit in. Like this, because on the top of the waterbuck's nose, it's very, very dark, so we need it shaded. And even put these markings in. And this marking on the other side. Okay, then the eye shading, top of the eye and then the bottom of the eye, and you have the light coming through. The same here, the bottom of the eye and the top of the eye. Okay, so underneath here he's got a little bit of a beard, like so. To rough it out. Fit in the heart. And the last thing to do just on the waterbuck is put some of these marks in as well. So you've got two different types of markings. You've got the black marker and you've got the pencil. And the pencil softens it. And all we need to do is the background. Looking very regal. Last line. Okay, so we need some of the background. We're going to just have a plant here, a twisted plant. Like that. We're going to have an exotic flower. And we're going to have serrated edge leaves. One, two. And another flower. Okay, then on the other side we're going to have and we're going to have a leaf cluster. Okay, and we're going to do those in black pen. Like so, and we'll have do this leaf in black pen too. And then we're going to put one or two creatures in the background. serrated edge leaf. Okay, we're going to draw a bird flying here. Going to have a wing there, then a wing upwards. Then you can have another wing here. Looks like he's just taken flight. And we're going to have an owl here. Another thing there. The beak and the face. And then we're going to have a butterfly here. Like that. I think that's probably enough. So let's just draw those in. It's a butterfly. This is the owl. Owls are very mysterious, particularly the way they can turn their head. The back is just really weird. Why can't we all do that, hmm? I fancy being able to do that. Bit of feathers, and a few more feathers on both sides. Then we have the bird flying. I think it must be a goose. I think it looks like he's just been eating too much food, so I might make him a little thinner. Put his feet in. And then Let's do then is the eye. And to finally finish it off, we need to do some rubbing out. Okay, so that's the end.